Today we're going to talk about 7.2, which is multiplying and dividing rational expressions. Really, the main rule is the same rule for 7.1. As long as it's multiplication, we can cancel like factors. So your first step should be factor everything as long as it's in multiplication form, and you can cancel any like factors. But I want to keep reminding you that it has to be multiplication for you to cancel. So we're going to start off with number one. It is a multiplication problem, so I can't cross out any like terms right now. That's really important. It has to be in factored form. So I'm going to pull out a GCF in the numerator of 2, and in the denominator of the second rational expression, I'm going to pull out a 5. Now that it's in factored form and it's a multiplication problem, I can cancel like factors. So I can cross out the r plus 2s, and this is again where you need to be careful. These are monomial terms, so I can cancel like terms. Again, when it's I can cancel like factors, and because these are monomials, you can cancel the r's because it's really 3 times r and 5 times r. So now we're going to bring across what's left. Please be careful about what's on the top in the numerator and what's in the denominator. So I'm left with 2 times 3 in the numerator, which is 6. 5 times 5, which is 25 in the denominator. Always scan your answer. Make sure you can't go any further. Please pause number 2. Go ahead and work it out. Factor it completely. When you think you're finished, come back to it and watch what I do. So I'm going to start off again by factoring out a GCF in the numerator. Denominator is a difference of squares. Numerator of the second rational expression is actually a perfect square. C minus 2, C minus 2. And be careful on this denominator. You see C squared, and a lot of y'all want to jump to a difference of squares, but this problem actually is just a GCF. So you can pull out a C, and you're left with a C minus 1. Now that it's in factored form and it's multiplication, I can cancel any like factors. And this is where a lot of people get caught up, as they think back to example 1 that it has to be a crisscross, and it doesn't, because multiplication really means multiply across. So it just has to be somewhere in the numerator and denominator. So these C plus 2s will cancel. This C minus 2 will cancel. And then again, be careful. In this case, those monomials of C's also cancel. So now we're going to be careful and bring across what's left over. And what's left over for this problem is a C minus 2 in the numerator and a C minus 1 in the denominator. If you are one that is going to try to keep going when you're not supposed to, just as I told you in 7.1, put parentheses around those. My math lab will not do this, but it will not mark it wrong if you have those parentheses there. For some of you, that helps you from trying to cancel something you're not supposed to. Going to division. And again, the key step for division is you have to flip it, multiply by the reciprocal of the second fraction. So some of you know the little saying where he says, keep, flip, and so forth. So in this case, I think keep, change, flip is what it says. So if that helps, you'd use it. But do not cancel anything until it's multiplication. Has to be multiplication to cancel like factors. That doesn't change. That's true always. You can cancel like factors if it's multiplication. So the first thing I'm going to do on number 3 is flip the second fraction. Now that it's multiplication, I'm going to factor any of the terms that I can. There's nothing to do for the first fraction. The second fraction, or rational expression is the more correct term to use there, is I can pull out a 3, and that would leave me with a 5p plus 2. Now that it's factored, I can cancel like factors because it's multiplication. So the 5p plus 2's cancel, multiply across, I'm left with 5 over 6 times 3, which is 18. Double check, I can't cancel anything there, so that's my final answer. Going to number four, last one for this section. And again, remember, these are just highlights that we're going over on these videos. Truthfully, you really need to watch the video organizers, especially in this chapter, to make sure you get more information, more examples to watch. So please make sure you're doing both of those pieces. But we always highlight what we know you tend to make mistakes on using our handouts. So we're going to start off by, again, making it a multiplication problem. So keep the first rational expression. And we're going to flip. And again, this has to be done first. Some of y'all will want to do two steps at once, and I just caution you from it, meaning that you want to factor at the same time. You can do that. It's just easy to forget to flip it. Remember, when you're factoring, you do need to show me your steps. If you're using the AC method, it's not okay just to magically split up the middle term. You need to show me how did you get that. So these problems are pretty easy that we should be able to do these in our heads, since it's a leading coefficient of a 1. So we have a y minus 3, y plus 1 for the numerator of the first rational expression. Denominator of the first one is, again, a perfect square, y plus 2. And some of you will want to write that as the y plus 2 quantity squared, which is okay. I tend to write it as two separate pieces, so it's easier to see what's left over. The numerator of the second rational expression can be factored to y plus 2, y minus 1. And the denominator is a difference of squares. So I've now factored it completely. It's a multiplication problem. Now I can cancel any like factors that are in the numerator and denominator. So a y plus 1 cancels, a y plus 2 cancels, and don't forget here, these y minus 1s cancel. So again, scanning what I have left over, I have left over a y minus 3 over a y plus 2. A big mistake in this chapter is to mix up what rules I use in which section, because there's really not a lot of separate rules. The first two sections use the same rule. As long as it's multiplication, factor everything and cancel like factors. Going to the next sections, two sections will be adding and subtracting. Those have the same rules. Going to 7576, those are solving problems. They have the same set of rules. So even though we have several sections on this test, it really is going to break down to three sets of rules for the first six sections. So make sure you keep reminding yourself, what do I do when it's multiplication and division? What do I do when I do adding and subtracting? Watch the extra videos in my math app to make sure you have these down pat.